Parang ano? Parang ano ba yan? Parang
teka muna, sandali. Digital image. Welcome back to Sipi Politics. Still with us, Transportation Secretary Mar Rojas. Okay, let's move on, no? From Gloria Arroyo and Naiya. It really gets your goat, ano? Talagang it can rally you up. Well, don't answer that question.
No. It doesn't get my goat. Frankly, you know, it's not personal or nothing. No? But I think you know me a long time, Pia. No? Mm. I try and exercise every day. Prudence. Mm-hmm. I try and exercise good judgment. And everything that I do, I have a test. I have an internal, what I consider to be the most stringent test, no, for any decision. Mm-hmm. And that is, if this was my money, what would I do? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And that's what leads to, oh, you first do this. Hindi yung barabarang gastos. Hindi yung basta-basta. Diba? You do it in an orderly way, sequential way, para hindi aksaya ang pera. And to have that impugned or to have that question baselessly, I think is unfair.
Okay. Well, speaking of decisions, no, this and we move now into politics. Not that this is not political, Gloria Arroyo. What would you say is the biggest, most difficult political decision that you ever made? Is it that decision for you to step aside for Noy Aquino?
Yes.
That was it, no?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Well, I think
the sacrifice.
Any thoughtful person would understand why it would be the most difficult decision that one would have to make. Mm-hmm.
Given everything that's transpired, so since that time until now, do you think it was the right decision?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Absolutely. Okay.
No, I mean, transformative change, Pia. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We are in a situation where the default outcome, meaning all things being the same, what would normally happen is matuwid, derecho, malinis. Mm-hmm. Diba? Yan ang SOP ngayon. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. E dati, ano ba yung SOP? Mm-hmm. Di ba ang pag-e-SOP? Oh. Ang SOP dati, ang pag-e-SOP. Eh. Uh-huh. Ngayon, the expectation, the default expectation, the default outcome, the default destiny of any transaction is malinis, matuwid. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I think that is really transformative. You talk to any businessman, major businessman particularly, and they will tell you the single biggest change that has come to this country is that malinis ang paggobyerno. Malacanang hindi humihingi. Mm-hmm. So that's what they say.
Mm-hmm. So, Malacanang hindi humihingi.
Oh. Mm-hmm. So, okay.
So you're saying your sacrifice was worth it?
What did I say?
Absolutely. Okay.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay. What do you think? Just so that you know, we gotta. This is a good lesson, kasi in politics and in history, you know. So, and I'm sure a lot of people want to hear you talk about it. What do you think went wrong, which led to your defeat in the vice presidential race?
I don't know. I don't give it much thought. I maybe for two reasons: self-preservation, or my sanity, or also preservation from breaking my heart. But but you know, you put it away, you put it in a box, and you set it aside. No.
Yeah.
I have a protest. It's going on. Pero I've left that to the lawyers. No. Mm-hmm. And the reason that I've continued with the protest is because I want to give honor and acknowledgement. Gusto kong pahalagahan. Lahat ng mahigit sa 14 million votes na mga tao na bumoto para sa akin, na pinapahalagahan ko ito, kinikilala ko ito, napapasalamat ako dito, hindi ko ito makakalimutan. And this is also my inspiration, no? To give honor, to give due value to all those na nagtiwala sa akin.
That's what makes me
be able to set that disappointment aside and continue.
Yeah, but you know, I'm curious, Mar. I hope you don't mind. No? Was it because nga, you know, there was all that talk about that you had sacrificed your own campaign for a while because nga si President Aquino was lagging behind in the survey. So medyo dun mo finocus yung efforts mo sa kampanya niya. Kaya ganun na nangyari. Medyo hindi natin nakita from behind.
Yeah, you're a journalist. Maybe better you talk to the people in the campaign kaysa ako magsabi.
Okay. But Okay, so we move forward, and then, you know, there was this whole, before you were appointed as DOTC secretary, this whole scenario where you were supposed to have been appointed chief of staff, no? Of course, when I say you were supposed to have been appointed, yun kasi yung balitang lumalabas, no? Apparently, and obviously, hindi yun na nangyari. Pero, what was the real deal on that?
I don't know. The president, I think, was in Australia or in some trip, Indonesia. Mm-hmm. I myself was caught off guard when the news came back that that was his intention. And as I said, water boy then, water boy now, which is, you know...
Basta sumusunod ka na lang.
Yeah, no, and we had a talk na you know, at some point, parang whenever you're ready, you know, and I said na, you know, given a chance, again, to give honor to all those who trusted in me, who voted for me, if there's an opportunity to help and to contribute in making real what we had fought for in the campaign, which is the Daang Matuwid, then why not, no? Mm-hmm. And in whatever capacity.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So it wasn't like you really wanted to be chief of staff. Although it would have been kind of weird, ano? Parang... Kung magiging confused yung mga tao sa Malacanang, sino masusunod? Si ES? Si CS?
I don't know. What happened was that Secretary Ping tendered his resignation. The president, you know, called me in, said, you know, exactly, I mean, what he said at his, in his statement at his press con, that... may sunog sa front lines, kailangan ka doon, rumisponde. So I said, yeah, sure, why not?
Mm-hmm. Although Jojo Ochoa had said that he did not oppose it.
Well, yeah, I didn't think that he did. Well, I didn't know. Because, you know, the circumstances were such that Secretary Ping's resignation, I think, took on a life of its own. Mm-hmm. It was a major... I don't know. I mean, and so the president felt that he wanted me to serve in that capacity, and I'm happy to do so.
Mm-hmm. Kamusta na ba yung Balay Samar?
Meron pa bang nun?
Meron pa ba nun? Meron pa ba nun?
Palagay ko, mga sa mga naghahanap na lang ng intriga ang may nagtatanong tungkol doon. I mean, there's one boss. Mm. That's Pinoy.
Yeah.
There's one objective, which is Daang Matuwid.
Yeah.
There's one agenda, which is the president's agenda.
Yeah.
There may be discussions and difference of opinion in how to get there, in the how, but these are all presented.
Yeah.
And the president decides.
Yeah.
So I think.
What do you say? All this should be set aside, and you know, let's stop this Balay Samar and.
Yeah. It's not an issue to me. Mm-hmm. It certainly doesn't. Wala naman akong nararamdaman na. Mm-hmm. Na ganun. So, you know, I think let me try. And, most people think kasi, most people remember, journalists in particular, that comment about Malacañang being a snake pit.
Yes.
Diba? Kaya parating maybe they imagine na, diba, snake pit nga, ganun. Mm-hmm. Pero let me say, I think two things, no? Ayaw ng aha sa Daang Matuwid, eh. Diba? Kasi matuwid nga yung daan, no?
And, at yung ahas, hindi.
And so, talagang namang walang snake pit, eh, no? And, mm-hmm. and if you take a look at, if you really analyze all the past reportage about infighting and so on and so forth, ano bang pinag-aawayan doon? Madalas, kontrata. Mm-hmm. Diba?
Yeah, kontrata or access to the president.
Well, I mean, the president is quite accessible. Mm-hmm. But
appointments, you know, who gets to you know, for one thing, no, ang sinasabi nga it's sa cabinet, sa gabinete, panay LP yan, panay balay yan, no. Pero hindi, medyo hindi kayo daw makapasok dun sa ibang mga posisyon.
Hindi naman. I don't consider it that way. I think the president just makes his appointments based on his best lights as to who would be in the best position to perform his duties. But let me just go back to the point.
Yeah, yeah.
The reason that there's no snake pit is because it's not a system where contracts are given out like lollipops, eh. Mm-hmm. Diba? Because Daang Matuwid nga, eh. Mm-hmm. Diba? Lahat ng kontrata dadaan sa tama, wasto, transparent na pamamaraan. Yeah, so it certainly minimizes all of this reason for what may have been infighting in the past. Oh.
But you know, the very careful way that the administration is treating all these contracts and handing them out, is that affecting the economy a little bit too much. You know, there is that criticism, eh, na parang,
yeah, there is,
teka muna, parang,
sobrang maingat.
Oh, sobrang maingat. Wala tuloy.
Okay,
wala tuloy.
Pero, let's take two scenarios, Pia. Strictly politics, nang pinag-uusapan natin, ang ingat ng gobyerno, sobrang, medyo mabagal, sobrang ine-examine. Kaysa, another strictly politics show nang pinag-uusapan dito, mga mababahong, maanumalyang kontrata, pagnanakaw ng pera ng bayan.
Yeah.
Which one would you much rather have?
No? Yeah, oo.
Diba?
But I think maybe
I think yung masinop, step by step, transparent process. In the end, in my experience in government, I've investigated things in the Senate. I've been DTI and I've been now DOTC for 4 months. 4 months, palang. steady, clear, transparent, masinop. In the end, is faster than shortcut, barabara. And sige lang, bahala na. Because the shortcut, bahala na, bara-bara, eventually gets stopped because of investigation, because of the bara-bara, because of the shortcut.
Okay.
Look at all the contracts, the problematic contracts that I now have to clean up at DOTC. Piatko, Naiya. GMA Roro. North Rail. Diba?
Okay.
I mean,
so you're saying better safe than sorry.
No, it's not safe
better
than sorry.
Sure,
better clear, transparent, masinop, you know, meticulous, and get it done step by step, stable. That way, kung meron mang mag-question, wala silang mahahanap dahil nasa tama.
Okay. We don't have enough time, so we can't go into all the details about your projects in the DOTC. And anyway, like you talked about it on Business Nightly, you know, in October. But my question is, will there be something, you know, very tangible that will be completed before the end of President Aquino's
Absolutely,
term?
Many things. I mean, in fact, just in a couple of weeks, we'll be starting the bid on about ₱1 billion worth of improvements for the LRT system. Early next year, we'll be putting out to bid the O&M and for the terminal of Lagindingan, which, by the way, is on track and will be completed by the end of next year, towards the end of next year.
Okay.
Puerto Princesa, congratulations to them. When we got word that they had won this underwater river Wonders of the World, then we fast-tracked our efforts with the Koreans on the Puerto Princesa expansion of the airport and so on and so forth to accommodate all of the tourists that we expect to be going to Palawan. And so many of these things are on track, they're on deck.
Okay.
It's slow, but it'll get there.
Yeah, okay. I want to ask just one or two questions about the DBP Ong Pin loan. Did you have anything to do with the internal investigation?
None.
Nada.
None
whatsoever.
I'm not in DBP. I mean, DOTC.
No, because ang sinasabi nga ulit, karamihan daw ng mga nasa new board, mga tao ni Mar Rojas. So, you know, they see your hand there.
I think that's mostly just coffee shop talk. Product of idle minds.
Okay. Is it product of idle minds also yung sinasabing, yung nangyayari daw sa inyo ni Cesar Purisima?
Ano nangyayari sa amin? We were just together yesterday. I think that maybe this government is so boring that people make up these things. Maybe we should encourage the president to increase his love life or something. But you know, because it's really fairly boring. It's steady. It's clean. It's transparent.
So you're saying people are nitpicking, looking for things.
No, I'm just making up things that just don't exist.
Okay, 2013. You know, there was something that was floated a few weeks back or a month or two back. Na, oh, Mar Rojas is going to run for Congress, and we're going to see a speaker, Mar Rojas.
I haven't even heard that.
Okay. Although you know, we were thinking, taka muna. So, speaker Mar Rojas in 2013. Ano yon? Parang springboard for the 2016 presidential election.
Wow, layo na nang dinating mo.
All I know is I'm running. Let's talk about politics.
All I know is I'm running, I'm losing weight, I've lost my tummy, I'm on a treadmill, and that's what I'm focused on.
Of course, I don't expect you to you know, to confirm. I mean, well, how can you say, you know, what you're going to do in 2013, 2016?
But the reality is, this, I'm not playing coy. I'm not playing.
It's a little bit too early to say with finality, right?
And those are major decisions. Mm. But quite seriously, whether it's 2013 or 2016, that's probably where you're going to go. Whether it's 2013 or 2016, my sincere desire is to see some of the fruits of our labors at DOTC come to pass.
Yeah, okay.
My desire is to see our people feeling and benefiting from the benefits of matuwid na daan. It's a worthwhile endeavor. I remember my father always telling me a lesson that he learned from his own mother about applying oneself to a worthwhile endeavor. If you're going to just make pawis and make pagod and have heartache and have whatever frustration and sacrifice and everything, make it a worthwhile endeavor, an endeavor that helps people, an endeavor that uplifts, an endeavor that, you know, that contributes. So it is a worthwhile endeavor, and you know, everybody is focused on that so that we can accomplish it.
Yeah. Will it make it easier if the Aquino administration is successful, no, by the end of his term?
Then we can all retire.
Then you can all retire, or you can have, as I remember, I was speaking with several LP people the night that you made that announcement that you were stepping aside for him. You know, if he wins, which was already parang sure win na siya, no? And if he does well, by 2016, pwedeng isa pang LP president, right? Parang yun ang byproduct, parang ganon.
That's so far away. I mean, who knows? Mm-hmm. Who knows what happens? By that time, Zio will be 4 years old. He'll be entering preschool, and if Pinoy's P12 program comes to pass, he'll be in kindergarten early with preschool pa, and you know that's what's important.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but you know, kanina kasi sabi mo, di ba, na magdininong ka raw kay Zio. Kaya lang, ninang kasi si Coring ng pangatlo namin. And speaking of Corina, nagtanong, di ba, si Ping Lacson nagtanong sa'yo sa Senate, sa confirmation hearing.
Well, who said it, I think, more in jest than...
Is there going to be a baby soon?
Well, it's in the trying that one lives life, di ba? Life is not in the destination. Life is in the trying and in the journey.
Okay, so my final question is, you're not... it's either you're running in 2013 and 2016 or you're staying the executive.
I'm sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
You're not paying attention. So you're not running in 2013, or you're going to stay in the executive?
Well, it's one or the other. Or I'll retire from government. Yeah, I mean, who knows? We'll see what happens. But what I want to do, since that's the last question, right?
Yeah.
Okay, but what I want to do after you've said the last question is to give you some flowers that I brought. It was a real honor.
Para to showbiz, no? Oh my God, wait, don't stand.
Let me just.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Because I know that this is a special, episode.
Okay, this is nice. It hides my tummy.
I just want to say I'm thankful that you asked me to be on this special episode. Yeah, so thank you very much. I'm honored for that.
And thank you very much, Secretary Maroz. We'll see you soon again. We'll have to take a short break. Strictly Politics will be right back. Stay with us.